Hola amigos, ¿qué tal? Stuart here from Spain Speaks with the Spain News Update. We'll take a look at some of the main stories that have caught my attention in the press here today in Spain, and we'll take a look at some comments that have been left on the channel in recent times by viewers. Before I begin, a huge thanks to all of the people that have supported the channel in recent times, whether it's by buying me a coffee, whether it's through the Super Thanks option on YouTube, longer-term supporters on Patreon, or the channel members of this YouTube channel. Thank you very much for your support. Now, straight into the news, and the death toll in the Valencian community continues to grow after the heavy storms that wreaked havoc in that part of Spain yesterday. And as we can read here, at least 51 people dead due to the devastating Dana that has ravaged the Valencian community. The devastating Dana that struck several areas of Castilla-La Mancha and the Valencian community on Tuesday, leaving at least 51 dead, is again bringing heavy rains and intense storms across much of the region on Wednesday. Over 50 fatalities, dozens of people trapped by floodwaters in various towns, widespread flooding, road and air traffic disruptions, and countless damages are the aftermath of the violent Dana. The Minister of Transport and Sustainable Mobility, Oscar Puente, announced via social media platform X that there will be no commuter train service in Valencia on Wednesday until weather conditions permit, and that the Madrid-Valencia line will be out of service until 10 a.m. The cold drop, or Dana, affecting the Valencian community is the worst of the 21st century, comparable to those of 1987 and 1982, the year of the Taos Dam disaster, according to the State Meteorological Agency's report. So 51 people unfortunately losing their lives as a result of that Dana weather phenomenon in the Valencian community, and countless more people still missing, and some horrific scenes caused by that storm. But what exactly is this weather phenomenon, the Dana, or the D-A-N-A? Well, as we can read here, a meteorological Dana, it stands for Depresión Aislada en Niveles Altos, or Isolated Depression at High Altitudes. According to AEMET, it results from the clash of a cold air mass at high altitude with warm surface air, leading to showers and storms. This phenomenon, traditionally known as a cold drop, produces intense showers and storms. The entry of a cold air mass in the upper atmosphere that encounters warmer air near the ground creates instability, encouraging the formation of storm-producing clouds. AEMET explains that a Dana has two types of causes: dynamic, related to the phenomenon itself, and thermodynamic, due to temperature differences, meaning it can occur at any time of the year. In the northern hemisphere and mid-latitudes, it is typical for storms and anticyclones to move from west to east, but occasionally undulations form, and one of these waves creates a sort of pocket of cold air that becomes isolated with a more erratic movement. This erratic movement is precisely what makes it harder to predict and constitutes a Dana. So fairly clear there that these Danas are very hard to predict, and that's why so many people get caught up in them. Sometimes they cause little or no damage, but on other occasions, like for example yesterday, the devastation is tremendous. Changing the subject now and on to Spain's inflation numbers. And as we can see, inflation rises to 1.8% in October due to higher fuel and electricity costs. Inflation rose in October, reaching 1.8%, 3/10 higher than in September, driven by increased fuel costs and, to a lesser extent, rising electricity and gas prices. This is according to preliminary data from the National Institute of Statistics. With this increase, Spain's CPI breaks a four-month trend of consecutive decline since last May, when it stood at 3.6%. Despite the October rise, the CPI remains at its most moderate levels in 3.5 years, specifically since March 2021, when it was 1.3%, and began an upward trajectory that reached 10.8% in the summer of 2022. Additionally, inflation in Spain remains below the European Central Bank's reference level for monetary policy action, set at 2%. So inflation on the rise again, but nowhere near the levels reached in 2022. Fortunately, indefinitely. And the final piece of news, and some bad news for Barcelona residents, because that city has a crime rate 50% higher than Madrid. The crime rate in Barcelona was 50% higher than in Madrid during the first half of 2024. According to data from the Ministry of the Interior, analysed by ACN, the rate in the Catalan capital was 48 crimes per 1,000 inhabitants, compared to 31 in the nation's capital. Nevertheless, the number of crimes slightly decreased in both cities compared to the same period in 2023. The number of recorded crimes in Barcelona between January and June 2024 was 79,777, excluding cybercrime, which is lower in absolute terms than Madrid's 103,378. However, in terms of population, Barcelona's crime rate is 50% above that of the Spanish capital. In Barcelona, crime levels have remained stable over the past 2 years, with a 1.2% decrease compared to 2023 and a drop of around 20,000 incidents compared to the last pre-pandemic year. So not a very flattering statistic for the city of Barcelona, a higher crime rate than in the capital city, Madrid. And is it just me, or is it time to get strict on crime in big cities here in Spain? Let me know your opinion in the comment section below. Now let's take a look at some comments that have been left on the channel recently. One here from Marco: wow, climate change in full view here just south of Valencia. The rain was so hard at one point it actually hurt to go out. Yeah, Marco, thanks for the comment, and I hope all viewers of this channel in the Valencian community are safe and sound today. 51 people, as we saw, currently listed as having lost their lives in that storm, and hopefully the death toll won't rise much further. But as I said, given some of the images that I have seen, I doubt that will be the case. One here from Cindy, Creator for Life: apparently Sanchez isn't hearing the anti-tourist sentiment of his constituents. Turning Spain into Hollywood or Bollywood seems counterproductive. Yes, Cindy, thanks for the comment, and obviously related to the fact that Mr. Sanchez is currently in India trying to convince the people there that Spain is a good country to invest in. And as I mentioned yesterday, he has the Bollywood industry in his sights. Over the past few years, Mr. Sanchez has been trying to turn Spain into an audiovisual hub by offering incentives to companies to film their television and film productions here. Some of the big players in Hollywood seem to have jumped on board, for example Netflix, and now he wants the Bollywood market. And maybe all of these people complaining about tourism here in Spain could become extras in a Bollywood production. I don't know, just putting it out there. One here from Keith in Valencia: thanks, Stuart, for publishing my comment. Sorry about the odd handle. I hope it is updated now to something more legible. I think the 40% is pie in the sky, but it is an interesting concept. Yeah, Keith, thanks for the comment, and I did have trouble with your YouTube handle yesterday, but now, fortunately, it's a lot easier to read. And the Podemos demand on the government to lower rents by 40% is, as you say, most likely pie in the sky. But it'll be interesting to see how Mr. Sanchez and company handle Podemos's demands in coming weeks and months. One here from Dude: mate, you've got to admit that just about any menú del día in Spain is a hell of a lot healthier than any pub meal deal that you could get in the majority of British franchise pubs across that lovely green country, the exception being Toby Carvery, a tenner for a healthy roast dinner. Yummy, yummy. Yeah, dude, thanks for the comment, and I think you could be right that a lot of the food items that you get on the traditional menú del día here in Spain are a lot healthier options than you'll find in some other countries. I can't really talk about what you find in British pubs nowadays because I haven't eaten in a British pub for a while, but I'll take your word for it. But if anybody else has anything to add to this conversation, leave it in the comment section below. The Spanish menú del día, is it a healthy meal in your opinion or not? And the final comment here from someone: lots of people hate the police until the day they need their services. Yes, someone, thanks for the comment, and I reckon you're on the mark with that comment too. Lots of people do complain about the police until they find themselves in a situation where they need the police's help. And my personal experience in this country as an abider of the law is that the police do a pretty good job. But again, just my opinion, you can have yours in the comment section below. On that note, I'm going to wrap the video up. Questions and comments, please leave them in that section below. If you have anything to add to the conversation, the comment section is the place for you. Give the video a thumbs up if you liked it, thumbs down if you didn't. I'll see you in the next one. Hasta luego.